Down here in the bottom left in our one-on-one map, we have our Protoss player. He
is Tati Aces.
And over here in the top right, our Blue Terran, a member of the Team OGS. He didn't do so well the last game. Can he pull through this time?
OGS time.
By the way, guys, be sure to send in questions. So Artosis.
GOMTV.net forums. I'll be giving an interview to the winner of this match right after it. But then you guys are going to have to just sit tight for like an hour or something till 8 p.m. Korean time so that you can watch Code S.
Yep.
Yay, Code S.
Chrono Boost for the probes. No proxy gateway.
Yep. Not surprised by that. You know, I feel a lot of the time on this map, like, Terran almost dictates, you know, because as far as early armies go, yeah, there's the Warp Gate Rush, which can be quite nice if Terran is teching. But if both players are going for armies, just low-tier army units, excuse me, I'm so sorry. The Terran army seems to be the one that gets on the offensive as opposed to Protoss. You have to use your force fields very cleverly, very carefully, very precisely to take out Sim Marines and Marauders early in the game. It really takes the big splash units of Protoss, the Colossus, the High Templar and such, to really deal with those armies more effectively. So as long as Top makes more than one barracks, I think he's going to control the tempo of this game.
One other thing to note is that it's not uncommon for players to try to mass up maybe three racks or three gates and push and try to contain the player at the bottom of his ramp.
I love that play using Protoss.
You can EMP the Protoss as they pour down. Using Protoss, you can force field the ramp when they try to get out. In that amount of time, you can take an expansion. Let's say the Terran gets some medevacs. You should know the timing for that. By then, you can go back home and just defend.
Yes, exactly. And we do not see that very much, but I tell you, in theory, it is cool as a cucumber.
It is. One that's been left in the fridge for days.
Yeah, that's right. Fridge is on a pretty cold setting, too.
Yeah.
You know, the one where you take out the milk, you take a sip, and it hurts your teeth?
Yeah. Some of it's frozen. You're like, oh, God damn it.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Everybody at home knows what I'm talking about. Now, the factory's on the way. So it looks like we're going to see a tech-oriented build.
Yep, definitely tech from OGS Top. I would not be surprised at all if it's a Raven build again. You know, he does have that second gas just finishing up. Meantime, Protoss has to get out his Stalker and chase away his SCV.
Starport, now under construction. Some Terrans do like to go for quick Banshee, too, on this map because there are so many Protosses that go for Warp Gate all in. And then, you know, you just counter that with a Banshee.
And it seems that Ace is doing a pretty safe and standard build so far. He went Gateway, Robotics, Gateway. So that's going to allow him to get out an Observer and see exactly what is going on. I am quite certain that's what he's going to get with his Robotics first. And if, in fact, Top is going to go for Banshees like you were suggesting, Caseless, this build that that Ace is doing is going to be quite nice against that, having those quick observers out.
Yes, certainly so. And it looks like we're going to get a Banshee on the way. Here we go.
Will he get cloaking?
That's the big question.
Yep, cloaking on the way, and Chrono boosting out that observer. So he's going to be ready in plenty of time to deal with the Banshee. And that gives him a little bit of an edge.
Yeah, Protoss is sizing up a little bit better so far. Build is a little bit safer. He's basically prepared for whatever aggressive move the Terran's going to do. Then it's going to be his turn to control the game.
Ooh, and our Protoss player, well, their Terran, as you see there, getting up to three barracks, and our Protoss getting four gateways total. So he's going to go four warp gates plus observers.
Yeah, I didn't expect that. I thought he was going to expand or something.
No, I thought so too. And in comes the factory, so Top is going to know exactly what's up. And if that factory doesn't go down, Faceless, It has not seen the other three warp gates yet. So he might be thinking, oh, it's another DT drop. A Raven is being made, though. And an Immortal being pushed right out. I think we may see Startail Ace just try to go ahead and bust top. It's definitely a possibility because, you know, he is just going Banshee, Marine, Marauder. There's a lot of sentries out. So, of course, you can force field behind the bunker, make it unrepairable.
That is just such an awesome ability.
Yeah.
That you can force field around the bunkers. That way they can't be repaired.
Quite true.
So cool.
Taking out that singular probe.
Wow, four gates, and he's teching to Immortals. He must have cut probes a while ago.
Yeah, it certainly does look like that. He only has 33 probes, up to 30 SCVs.
Well, never mind then.
The Banshee, he has canceled Cloak, so that was very smart when he scouted. Oh, there's Observers around. Never mind. Cloak is worthless. And the Raven is out, as you see, just pumping a bunch of units. For upgrades, he's getting Stim and Concussive Shells. So definitely we're going to see a very similar build that we saw from Top in Game 1 on Scrap Station.
Now, the Factory is still around the map. He can still scout with that. And, you know, I got to say, both these guys one-basing pretty hard. That Terran should basically see everything the Protoss has. Mm. Nobody's budging, though. Nobody's expanding.
You know, I like the fact that he has a couple of Immortals in his army as well.
Yeah,
if he targets those just right on Marauders during the battle, they're going to make a world of difference. Dealing 50 damage a shot to the Marauders, even Marauders don't live through that very long.
No, Immortals are just such cool units. They work in such a unique way. Oh.
So many sentries.
Perhaps too many sentries.
You know, that's... They're definitely going to be quite useful. As we saw last game, he's actually so good at force fielding the Terran army. You know, he won that one battle against Top that I really was not sure he was going to crush that army so easily and just force fielded like 1,000 times and bam, there you go. Your units aren't firing at mine. That's all I need. But they are both actually going to expand from here. This is so interesting because both of them are doing very aggressive-oriented builds, although, of course, as I was saying, we're going to see more of a defensive opening from the Protoss player just because it's scary to get attacked by Stim Marines and Marauders this early in the game.
Looks like Protoss is going to go for a late contain here. He just wants to intercept anything that Mace try to scout him.
He may, Terran in fact, spots move in, though.
Oh,
it looks like
Protoss
he's going to move
gonna
into
attack.
The Terran base and throwing up that Guardian Shield. That's going to help a lot. It's going to take a lot of damage. And beautiful force fields going up so he can trap the units in the bunkers. And those will die quite quickly. The Marauders being worth their weight in gold right now. Just absolutely killing off these Marauders with the Mortals. And very nice attack here.
But
will he finish off the armor?
With the Immortal gone, it's just these Stalkers and Sentries. Sentries aren't exactly damage dealers.
That's quite right. And as you see, as the other units fall down, quickly do the Sentries as well. And Top does end up holding it off.
He does have a few more units, though, here. He may go in and try to attack again before the bunkers finish.
I gotta say, that would not be very wise.
Be terrible
He's
idea.
Down in supply right now. It's 61-71. Top in the lead there. And Top's gonna be able to rally out very quickly out of his three barracks and starport. In fact, he is adding Banshees right now, as we see on the production tab there. And the Banshee's gonna help out a ton because he spent most of his gas on weaker anti-air units such as the Sentry.
Another Banshee coming. Protoss does have an Immortal. He may try to attack again. If he does attack, he's got to protect the Immortal and allow the Immortal to do its necessary damage. Again, the force fields. He's over force fielding. He's blocking off his own Zealots.
You know, trying to trap units, but really not killing as much as he would want.
Yeah, so, he was just blocking himself off back there.
Yeah. So both players, they have expanded now. The supply's a lot evener. More even. Evener. Yeah.
Whatever suits your fancy.
Yeah. Just slightly more probes than SCVs at 43-39. And we see no additional tech yet for Startail Ace. Now, that can turn out to be a really big problem because right now the Terran actually has more tech. And The Marine Marauder Medivac combo with Stim is quite good against Techless Protoss. His only tech really is the Immortals, so we'll have to see. And it looks like Top's starting to move in here.
He's going to try to trigger them to get forward. Oh, nice.
Very interesting.
Point defense thrown here. He's going to take out some sentries, or suckers, excuse me.
And the point defense drone does get used up. I'm actually surprised he doesn't use some force fields to lock those units into the cliff area and actually pelt them from above. He does have a lot of stalkers, as well as immortals, which could do a decent job there.
Banshee goes down. Now we have Robotics Bay on the way, so he wants to get to a Colossus. If Terran regroups and attacks before their Colossus comes out, it could be game.
Yeah. That's very true. He's going to have a quite weak point while he is teching up to that Colossus. It costs a lot of money and a lot of time to get that first one, two Colossuses out, to get that Thermal Lance upgrade. And during those times, it's natural for the Terran to just have more units.
So that pylon's still not spotted. Both gas is finishing now. And right when I said that pylon was not spotted, Stop goes in and takes it out. Terran with just a slight lead here.
Yeah.
Because Terran is not over investing himself. But Protoss' army is looking pretty damn solid.
Yeah,
perfect mixture.
It is quite solid, that's true. He has a decent number of sentries and immortals in there, but ghosts are being made right now for Top. So the ghosts definitely going to help out if they can snap off those immortal shields. But at the same time, ghosts not all that useful against Colossus, which is actually the tech that we do have Sartelius going for right now.
Seems like normally if we see somebody be immortal dependent in the mid game and early game, then we're going to see them switch to High Templars and Zealots with legs. But in this case, he's going to go for Colossus.
Yeah. Top right now getting quite a fearsome army out. It's a bunch of scouting going around the map. SCV meets Probe. SCV and Probe do not fall in love. SCV leaves Probe.
Nice denial of scouting. Okay, here it comes, Artosis.
This is a fearsome army. There's only one Colossus out. Thermalance just about to finish.
If he gets up an EMP, there he goes.
Did not get all the sentries there. Only got one. And I'm actually surprised he did that little force field group. Would have been nice to try to trap some of them.
I think he's being very, very cautious here. And once again, he's going to move in here and try to take out...
Probably a point defense drone coming up.
Oh.
And trapping a lot of the units on the low ground there is going to help this Colossus to really do a lot of damage. Immortal in the front firing quite a bit as well. And Top, I do not know. This was not the greatest move in the entire world. In fact, I have to say it was kind of a poor move. You don't really want to engage in a situation like that. Yeah, the Zealots can't attack, but the greater range of the Protoss army overall is going to punish you there. You really want to be more spread out in an area where the force fields aren't going to be quite as powerful.
Counter. Counterattack over here. He's moving it. And Stim. The Zealots are in the back, though. Bad positioning. He needs those Zealots in the front so the Stalkers can deal the damage. The Zealots can tank it.
Quite true.
The Colossuses are just doing too much.
There's a lot of Vikings out now, but still plenty of Protoss units, but they are starting to get trampled a little bit. You know, I'm actually really surprised and disappointed that they both just attack each other in that order. Realistically, when you're both just sitting on two base making units, no one should be able to kill each other.
Yeah.
What you should do is expand.
The Artosis rule. You don't have to kill them.
Yeah, you do
not.
You
get a lead, keep a lead, and wait for them to do something stupid to try to kill you.
And if it's even, don't just try to go kill them either. In fact, don't try to go kill your opponent. Just don't do it. There are situations where you should, but you can learn about that later. Most pro gamers don't even know what they are.
Now, the medevac is chased out. You know, when you see the Colossus, you have to switch to Vikings right away. But that means no more medevacs, which means when you're doing drops like this, you got to be damn careful. Because if you lose a few medevacs, not only do you not get to harass anymore, but you don't get to heal your army.
Yeah. all sorts of multi-pronged harassment with Banshees and Medivacs still going on. And I gotta tell you, man, it's time for these guys to take third bases, and I think they're both finally realizing it that, oh, maybe we can't kill each other off of two bases! And a Nexus does go up for...
There it is.
Yeah, and a Command Center is flying over to the third base of OGS Top. So it looks like both of them will be taking bases.
Stalker's actually faster than Banshees on foot. Give me some kind of idea. Just imagine that.
That's like really fast.
That is
Banshee
like
is some
so
sort of airplane, man.
Yeah.
Stalkers are quick.
The probe spots the expansion. With the probes transferred. We may see an attack here, even though it's not exactly what you're supposed to do. Wouldn't shock me.
When you first expand, that's like the worst time in the entire world to attack. The absolute worst.
Yeah, because you spend all that money on a command center instead of a second barracks, for instance.
Gotta wait for it to kick in.
And more units. Yeah.
Now, Top is moving out. It's almost a purely Marauder army. Just Marauders and Vikings. It's gonna be a very tough army to deal with. There are four Colossus out. It's gonna have to use Force Fields and Guardian Shields very, very well in this battle if he's gonna want to live through it, because right now, Top does have a decent supply lead. He's up by about 40 supply at 162 to 127.
He's debating doing it.
Threatening him with a single force field on the ramp.
Now he could peek up here with a few Marauders stim and try to kill that Nexus. Then run up the ramp. I don't know.
Yeah, that if he wants to get up the ramp, that's definitely Tasis an excellent way to do it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Here's a cookie.
We're just too polite, guys. Lots and lots of Vikings here. You got to make sure those Colossuses are protected underneath these
Colossuses.
I'm trying to speak with marbles in my mouth. You got to make sure they're protected by the Stalkers. And now he's going to go in here from a different angle. Oh my God!
Wow.
One down.
Snipes off one Colossus. A huge move right there. Only losing a Viking or two. And he's going to go for it.
Uh-oh.
Lots of force fields. Here come in the Vikings. He's got to keep those Marauders back so that he can kill off the Vikings with these Stalkers.
Unbelievable.
But,
he took out all of them.
Looks like Top is going to easily plow through the rest of this army.
Very nice. Very patient. He deserves this win. He's going to get the Nexus, and that would be GG.
Yes, it will.
Boom.
Last Colossus going down.
Mule dis. I love dropping the mule. Very nice. Oh, puts
the
mule on patrol.
GG.
GG. Wow.
And OGS Top does advance to the top 16 of Code A. So he will be at least Code A next season, no matter what. In the meantime, our poor Startail Ace, he is going to be fighting for his life against some Code Beaters.
Yeah, no kidding. That's brutal. Mm-hmm. So Code was not Code Ace. Code A here. See some interesting games thus far. But Top, definitely the better player.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be a pretty even match. It was.
Yeah, it was a pretty even match. But I would like to criticize that last game a little bit, if you don't mind, Tasteless.
Sure. Please.
They just kept attacking each other when they absolutely should not have.
Yeah.
For instance, if Startail's Ace had played just completely defensive the entire game, he would have won. There's really not much of a question there. He lost huge chunks of his army trying to get aggressive when he shouldn't have.
Yeah, I mean, they're both one-basing so hard. It's like, well, in all my practice games, I attacked. In all the latter games I've won, I attacked. But that's because
people weren't
one-basing.
Yeah, and not only that, but these type of moves are still working because people aren't great at the game yet.
Yeah.
So,
people are learning. People are pretty smart. You and me know all about that, Artosis.
Oh, yeah.
But let's just take a look at today's results. Throw them up on the screen. We have the bye for the first game. So Alive from TSL just gets to move on. Secondly, we have ST Ace against OGS Top. That was an interesting series, pretty close. But OGS Top came out, guess what, on top.
Wow. All right, tomorrow's Code A. Oh, my God. It's going to be ST Squirtle, a.k.a. Go Boogie, against Tarius, the nefarious Foyu. Then we're going to have JSL Zenith, the Slayer of Nada, in the last qualifier round.
Yeah.
Against SC4U, a PVZ and a TVT. Looks pretty exciting. Some high-level players there. But tonight, we have Code S in 1 hour.
I cannot wait. Yeah, it's exactly 1 hour. Yep, Code S. Going to be coming up here in just a little bit.
And here are the matches we're going to have. Hangun Prime.we against OGS The Wind. Ooh. And Slayer's Boxer against OGS Hyperdub. And don't forget, we're going to see 5 to 6 games between all these players.
Yep.
As they jockey for position 1 through 4 in the group.
Yeah.
Probably no one will be jockeying for 4th, though. Probably just jockeying for 1 through 3, and someone just is like, I'm a terrible jockey.
Guys, thanks to our sponsors at Sony Ericsson. We love you guys.
Interview coming up.
Interview coming up. Much love from Korea, Seoul, Korea. And I'll see you guys in an hour. Enjoy the interview.